The competition phase of the Ibadan Auditions is now but a distant memory, and the judges' decisions to select the best athletes from Ibadan's top 50 for their bootcamp squads are well underway. Already, between the three of them, coaches Aliu, Alozie, and Obikwelu have selected 16 athletes so far, but each coach only has 20 tickets for their bootcamp squads, and they will already be thinking about saving some of these tickets for the upcoming Enugu auditions.
I already get two. The one that impressed me, you've been taking them, so I can't do anything embarrassed.
For me, I want to be on the safe side. The people I give my card, I'll be honest with you, are based on merit.
Maybe I can just pick one more.
What makes you think you'll get better at it in Enugu?
Exactly, that's the risk of it, that's the beauty of it.
So you want to take it?
I'll take a risk.
Well, for me, I think I'm done with Ibadan.
Okay.
The ticket I have now, probably, yeah, I can spare one or two. Maybe
but
one.
You shouldn't worry about that.
I can spare one more for Ibadan, but I'll reserve the rest for
Ibadan. No, you don't need to worry. I have enough to give you.
Now the decisions get tougher. The 400 meters boys and girls in the top 50 who finished outside the first three in the finals will have to face the judges panel together. This time, the judges first deliberate together to decide who will be saved before making their individual selections. The coaches decide to save Victoria Chukwuma, who finished fifth in the girls 400 meters, and they also save Segun Aigbe and Saeed Jimo, who were 4th and 5th respectively in the boys' race.
She has a very good talent. She's very nervous and she's very scared and running. Aigbe, you amaze me the way you run in your semis. To be honest with you, I'm very tough as a judge. As a 400 meters runner, you have to be tall. For me, you can go on doing the sprinting. I may be wrong as a judge, but look, this is what I can see as my opinion.
Now it's time for the judges to pick or pass on the saved athletes. Obikwelu picks Victoria Chukwuma, while Alozie selects Segun Aigbe, leaving Jimo Saeed to be chosen by Team Aliu.
Hello. Yeah, good evening. Like, seriously, I was excited. Hey, I was so happy. Like, finally, I got someone who picked me. It's a thing of joy, it's a thing of joy anyway. Me seeing people who run faster than me, I'm always scared anyway. Yeah, he said he can try to remove the fear from me, and me myself, I think training with him, I'll become a star. Ah, Olympics awaits me, yeah. I'll become a star anyway.
I was happy. And he selected me, and he's my coach already. But I was happy he selected me. The Lagos audition was okay. But I know it's a little tough. Real life was a little tough.
It was only glory Alozie that selected me. I was not really disappointed because I was actually expecting her to choose me.
Who would the judges like to save from the remaining 100 and 200 meters girls in the top 50 who didn't finish on the podium in the finals?
Girls, I would like to comment on each and every one of you. You all did well. I must say congratulations for that. We have limited tickets. We cannot pick everyone, but it doesn't mean that you are not good.
Keep on training. You guys are young.
So you step forward.
Zainab Ibilade is a secondary school classmate of Barakat Kazim and also contested both the 100 and 200 meters barefoot.
What can you deliver to us? Because it was a risk for me to risk my card.
I didn't have much to say. Give me your card. I'll give you anything else.
What was your position during the race?
Olympic.
Yeah.
First.
On 200.
Did you do the 200?
What did you do the 200?
What did you do?
Fifth.
When I saw you the first time, I thought you're from Ethiopia. You run a long distance, you know. I have to be honest with you.
Long distance.
No one wants to give any card, so I'm going to give you my card just like that. So you just have to come and take it.
I was selected by Coach Ebikwale. I was not afraid that I was not going to pick the pink because Olympic is just to participate, not to be, not to win. Yeah, and now because there's still next year. I'll try and do better next year.
There are two groups for the remaining 100 and 200 meters boys in the top 50. The first group enters the decision room to see which of them will be saved by the judges.
You all did very well. I would have loved to have every one of you on our team, but we have a ticket constraint. We don't have enough tickets. I don't want any of you to feel bad. This is not the end of the road. There's still going to be more opportunity whereby you guys can still come into the team.
One thing I assure you that the wonders we pick is not, they're not sure if they're going to be. You can come and beat them. I'm not sure we're going to pick anybody in this team, so I'm going to see you guys next time and let's see when the race is going to start again. Alright?
You are not being picked does not mean that you are not good. You are all good, but you cannot pick everyone.
The second group of 100 and 200 meters boy sprinters go before the judges, and they are the last athletes who could still get tickets to boot camp at the Ibadan Auditions.
If they don't pick you in this team, if I don't do anything, please just take it as a challenge with the hate, you know, friends will be good, I don't like you. Good.
Ultimately, David Charles, Tolulope Adeyi, Onengi Ikoko, and Innocent Ata are saved by the judges. The team selections for David, Tolulope, and Innocent are straightforward, as they are snapped up by Team Obikwelu, Team Alozie, and Team Ali respectively.
Congratulations, man. I pick you because you have the heart.
I hope you make use of this among us, eh?
This is what, don't break my hand, though.
What are you doing?
I'm choosing you because I think you can do better than what you're doing.
Gloria! Carlos! I believe in challenges. You just can't remain within your four walls and claim a champion.
I came sixth in the 100 and fourth in the 200 meters. I was very confident of myself because on one or two occasions I've spoken with the coaches and they all see the talent in me.
My name is Charles Utibe David, aka Young Boat. Coach Francis Obikwelu, he had so many records and he was a quarter miler and also a sprinter.
The last athlete in Ibadan's top 50 for boot camp selections is Onengi Ikoko. He won the 100 meters at the Lagos auditions and was the fastest in the heats in Ibadan with 10.6 seconds, but he only managed 8th place in the 100 meters final and then finished 10th in the 200 meters final. Which of the judges will choose him for their squad?
I'm not picking you because of the talent. I'm not picking you for... I'm just wasting my card. To be honest with you, you can choose whoever you want. But the thing is that you have a bunch of talent. But what I don't like about you, you're too... Like, you feel that you are the best. You have to be humble.
The reason why I want to have you on my team, because I think I can work with your deficiency. And I can put you in order.
If I have you, I already face it already.
Just make your choice. Don't mind or their sweet minds.
Stop, right? Let's go. Let's take my card off.
Okay.
Yeah? Alright. Starting from today, be humble. You saw what happened today.
Today was bad. Everybody has their days. Today was just not my day. It's my first ever worst defeat today. I came last in both races. Francis Obikwelu went straight to the point. He told me that I'm a very proud athlete, which is very true. Deji Alu told me I was a very good athlete as well. He basically told me what I wanted to hear. That's what he did. But what really made me pick Francis Obikwelu was that he basically just gave it to me wrong. I'm going to kill this pride because that's one thing that's really killing me. It's really bringing me down. I have a very large ego. I need to cut it down to size.
All that is left is for the top sprinter judges to recap on what has been a memorable weekend at the Ibadan auditions.
It was a very tough decision.
Yeah, it was.
There was some athletes I was looking forward to have on my team, but because of the limited card, you know.
Yeah, for me, my side, you know, I didn't pick much. You know how it is, you know. sometimes I have to be tough, sometimes I have to be flexible. So that's it's normal. But I'm satisfied with the six I did. I picked they're quite well the youngest. For me, the amazing the girl who is the girl that ran the diff, that girl for me is I might be wrong, but for her to run 100 and 200 barefooted and make it up to top three.
I just picked it, and I don't know in any way I might see people or not, but maybe I will see.
Are you not scared that probably we might get to Enugu and you start having a flashback like, ah, and I've
like
left some, you know, I've left behind some.
You know, you should know me better, so you know I'm not the kind of person who regrets in my life what I do. Mm. You know, so I always do whatever my heart tells me to do.
I'll be honest with you guys, probably by the time we get to Enugu, it's going to be more difficult for both of you. For me, I'm going to be on the fence in Enugu.
These children, right? I know that today they must have gone home very happy. And
oh, no, that's for sure. They all left,
they all left happy
and...
I'm telling you, I'm so happy.
They have good tales to tell their parents, they have, you know, their peers and their folk back home.
Good job, man.
You know, good job.
Good job, Gloria.
Good job, I'm so happy to see you.
I'm happy to see you.
I know you didn't like me to take you, also, but you know, as a judge now.
Weekend judge.
Oh, okay.
Next time on Top Sprinter Genesis. The auditions move over to Enugu for the Nigeria East Auditions, where the stakes will be raised even further as nearly 200 athletes, including the top junior internationals from all over Nigeria, storm the Nnamdi Azikiwe Stadium for their chance to be part of the top sprinter train. There will be several twists and turns in store for the athletes, including a fourth Olympic medalist to be added to the panel of judges in the decision room as the athletes fight for a place at Bootcamp. As the Top Sprinter Genesis auditions reach their halfway point, whose race will fall apart as they emerge from the bend, and who will accelerate out of the curve to future stardom as a top sprinter? It's time to unleash the speedsters in the East.